Warning. This video contains footage of people being attacked in or near assumed safe spawn areas. This is in order to open a dialogue on the subject. If this upsets you, I am sorry, but the problem has to be highlighted in order to talk about the problem. G'day all, MrPaladin here, and today I want to have a conversation with you. This is a conversation that can upset many people because some view the subject matter as being mean or unsportsmanlike. I have uploaded videos on the subject before, and I will preface this video with clarifying my stance on the subject before we get into the meat of the matter. Let's talk about the way spawns are built in TF2, how you spawn, and why spawn camping even exists. Now, I understand that spawn camping exists because of the mechanics of how you spawn, where you spawn, and how well the map protects you at your spawn. Unfortunately, in TF2, there are attack and defend game modes that will give the defense time to set up and reach a full strength on a defense just outside of your attacking spawn. And if your team that is on the offense fails to prepare for that defense, when the gate opens, it gives the defenders a chance to attack from within your supposed safe place. In reality, however, there is no safe place in TF2. There is no imaginary line where a death suddenly becomes honorable over any other death. Because if you start to debate what is fair and what is not fair, you could begin pushing that line back and forth based on each person's personal opinion. Is it fair to be killed in spawn? No? Well, how about as soon as you exit the spawn door? Nah, that could be camped too. So how about allowing the enemy halfway towards the first capture point before killing them? You meanie. You should not hurt their feelings. You have 4 capture points. Let them cap first and then murder them. You can see how silly this subject can get. I choose not to draw a line. If the game mechanic allows you to be killed, then you should be careful from the moment you spawn because you just might be killed. If an enemy gets to my spawn door and I die, well, it sucks to be us. We should have worked together and communicated so this could not happen. Under the current game mechanics, the moment you spawn, you are in danger of death and respawning. If one enemy or a team of enemies pressures you or your spawn, you should work together with your teammates to bust out and push them back, even if this means some of you die in the process. Do I think this is cheap? Yeah, it's pretty cheap kills. Do I think it's easy? Sometimes. But plays like this sometimes even make it into high level comp play, where a demo man will sticky jump forward and go to the next spawn in anticipation of the enemy team spawning right at their spawn door. Now that all that is said, and I've said in the past that spawning should be safer, you should never feel like you're spawning into danger, and either Valve or map makers should fix problems in maps so that when you are within your spawn, you are safe, and leaving your spawn should not be as hazardous to you as it has been. You also don't want to give too much of an advantage to players that spawn, because sometimes the final defense points on maps have spawn doors that exist that are already at a huge advantage to a defense. You have seen in this video how there are several maps in the game that have sight lines straight into spawn that the defending team with a strong defense could unload fire right into a spawning area. What was the map maker thinking? That random people on the internet were going to be honorable enough to trust that they will not do it? Or that if it gets done that it was somehow fair? I really have no idea. What about Valve? Many of these original maps were from the original Team Fortress and Team Fortress Classic. The problem of spawn camping in Team Fortress is not a new one. Spawn camping has been done in the past in Team Fortress, and in almost every online combat game that I can remember. It was even in Team Fortress Classic, which is one of the games in Valve's portfolio. Team Fortress Classic took care of the problem with grenades and roof turrets. Enemies camping a spawn had little or no access to grenades, but the spawners had a pack and it was handy to refill on, so you could simply spam the enemy away from your spawn door. On top of that, the spawn had a roof turret that would drop down from the spawn roof to deter spawn campers or anyone who managed to make it into spawn. Finally, the maps had multiple spawn rooms or spawn exits. This was limited as much as possible to keep the size of the map down, you know, the whole polygon frame rate thing. In Team Fortress 2, however, you have so many spawns that are only protected by a solid spawn door. Not only that, you can't see through the spawn door, and it would seem to give your enemy more of an advantage to defend or attack than you in that place where you should be the strongest. Your spawn should be a place where you are the safest and strongest you could possibly be in the entire map, and it's simply not the case. So I stopped to think, what map is doing this right? Or in what way has Valve combated this problem? Let's take a look at this clip where I'm at the end of Gold Rush. This spawn would seem like it's good. It's got three spawn exits, with the upper spawn and the two lower spawns. But it is also near the final objective of the map, so you don't want to give the defenders too much strength. But as you can see here, they're still bottlenecked by going up this little ramp, falling easy prey to a bit of a camp. Since there are so many maps already made, let's not try and fix all the maps and instead turn our attention to Valve. Because there are game modes with safe spawns already in place. The robots in MVM seem to have fine time spawning and getting to a spawn line before they can get damaged. Why not put a mechanic like that into a game? Or let's look at manpower, which starts you off with an Uber. A personal Uber that can be abused a little in order to rocket jump up. But if the timing on it gets tweaked a little, you could definitely spawn safely. Making it back, however, could be a problem.
Oh no.
I think if an Uber protection, like what is in manpower, is put into a part of the core game with the timing tweaked so that you can't get too far with that Uber, I think it could work. I don't think it would upset an offense or a defense to have it. Even heavies can abuse the Uber just a touch. So let's cut it back a notch, so it protects you at spawn, but can't be abused. Now, a map that I think's got it right is the map Snowy Coast. Developed and created by Kep Eakum Pump and Fission Metroid 101. They've really listened to the community with this map, and when it was originally made, the spawns were terrible and was often camped. But now about every spawn has more than one spawn exit. Spawns are placed at various places so they don't get camped, with the final spawn having several exits that shift around depending on how far the bomb has progressed. They really listen to the community, and I've not been in a game on Snowy Coast recently where the spawns have been camped. So in this way, map makers could have a go at fixing the spawn problem, but I think it'll be easier if Valve addressed the issue. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Giorno di torno girando, delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sento a toncino d'amor. Delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sento a toncino d'amor.